Sorry about that. It looks like it. We thought we were broadcasting, but it was not pushing out to YouTube. I apologize for that. The first inning. My name is Zach Land, joined by Mike Leafgreen. We thought we were streaming that entire first inning, but apparently YouTube was not receiving our signal. But they are now. So we just talked through the first inning. We're back to the top of the second. Olivia Thornton takes a ball, and the first inning you didn't miss much. Three up and three down for both West and for Rogers. So I apologize for that technical difficulty, but we should be good now. What a flare right over Riley Johnson's head. Sorry about that, Coach.
No, it's good. Yeah, like Zach said, we had a 3-up, 3-down inning for both Lady Mounties and Lady Wolverines. So stop top of the second here. Eva Reif with that bouncer to shortstop. So she's on first. And now batting number four, Jaden Willard, the shortstop for the Lady Wolverines.
First pitch strike.
Off speed, just a little bit outside, 1-1. It was a good change of pace, trying to see if Willard would go for it. Out. So Ava comes in tonight. This is her seventh start of the year. She's 6-0. She's thrown 31 innings, 58 strikeouts, and is leading the team with a .452 ERA.
They're just screaming down there in the dugout. Tell you what, going from baseball last night, the softball tonight. Checks the runner at first. It's back safely. From baseball last night to softball, it's just an entirely different environment.
Yeah, they are communicating all night long.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter if they're tied, if they're up 10 or down 10. Both teams get after it and make it an entertaining event. The last pitch was called a ball, so 2-2. And we got a strikeout. So one down in the bottom of the second. With a runner on first base, we've got number 19, the designated player, Katie Leonard. Swing at a high strike, 0-1. Great pitch outside. She'd given her two high fastballs and the off-speed pitch away. She got two down. Now batting the first baseman, Maddie Axe. Swing and strike one. Two. Talon Jackson behind the plate getting the pitch calls from the dugout.
High fastball right by her.
Yeah, so we got the ground out single by Eva Reif, and then three straight strikeouts to end the inning. So the Mounties come into tonight with a 16-1 record, 8-1 in conference. They are tied for first place with Springdale Harbor. Bentonville West has a 12-8 record and 6-3 in conference. Here in a couple weeks, Rogers will have a rematch, April 22nd with Springdale Harbor. And if both teams continue on their trajectory, that'll be a great matchup to figure out some placements for playoffs.
Said April 22nd, right?
April 22nd.
I think we're at third place. It's here?
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Yeah, first game of the series, we were at Springdale Harbor. It was, I think, our second or third game of the year. And they beat us 6-1. That was our only loss in conference. Springdale Harbor lost last week or the week before to Bentonville 1-0. So we're both just with one loss in conference. Both teams playing really well. Lady Mounties under first-year head coach Tori Stafford. Again, 16-1 record, 8-1 in conference. She's got the Lady Mounties playing really well, playing as a team. Just very crisp. You watch them in pregame warm-ups, watch them in practice. There's a sense of urgency with the things that they do. So it's fun to watch. Catcher Talon Jackson leading off the bottom of the second. On the mound for Lady Wolverines, Mabry Van Ess.
And they are sisters or twins? Mabry and Laney.
I think sisters.
Sisters?
Mm-hmm. And Mabry had a 3-up, 3-down inning, also had two straight. Just like that. First inning, she had two straight ground outs back to the pitcher, pitcher to first base. So that's three out of four batters that are gone grounding right back at the pitcher.
Right back at her.
And so she's doing something to get them off balance and fool them a little bit where they're not getting a good bat on the ball. Now batting the first baseman, number two, Lauren Heinle. Out to left field. And it's caught by Kaylee Parker. Now batting the center fielder, number six, Mac Fithian. Mac comes in the game with a .350 batting average.
A high there.
Fouled off to the left. 1-2 count, two down. Swing and a miss. Three up, three down inning again for the Lady Mounties. And through two, score remains 0-0.
Tell you what, tonight is a lot different than last night. We got a little bit of cloud coverage. It was about 70 degrees at first pitch. Cooled off a couple degrees here, but cloud coverage. It's a little windy, but last night the ball was really carrying to left field in the baseball game.
Yeah, that was evident. First inning, bottom of the first, Jacob Watson hitting one out to left.
Yeah. Yeah, and it just carried. It just kept going. The left fielder, you saw him back up, and it just kept carrying. I don't think we have quite the wind here tonight. pushing the ball out. If anything, it's coming in from right field, mm-hmm. Which is what because that was Ava hit one out to right field. Apologize. Ava hit one out to right field, and it just kept holding up.
Yeah, in the first inning. Yeah, she hit one right to the wall. Just missed it by an inch. So fly out to Ashlyn Hewlett to start off the third inning. Now batting the 9 hole, number 3, Kaylee Parker. Bunted foul. Foul back, 0-2 count. Get one down in the top of the third.
Check swing, call.
And she went.
Yep.
Two down, back to the top of the order. Number 7, Stephanie Crittenden led off the game with a fly out to Kylie Kelly. Nice diving play.
Oh.
And Stephanie Crittenden's safe at first base. That was a great play by the shortstop.
It's Tumala.
Nahana Tumala.
Tumala, yeah.
Yeah, that's one thing you see with a softball diamond versus baseball. You know, the baseball field, you might be able to get that runner going to first. That's a hard play to make in softball with the bases being a little bit closer. Once she dives for that, gets back up, it's tough to make the throw to first. A second hit for West. Both of them stayed in the infield. We had a chopper in the second inning that got to Dahana, and then that little ground ball there that she dove for. But neither hit so far has left the infield.
She chases one outside there a little bit.
Yeah, maybe Van Ness, the pitcher. First inning, she popped up. Foul ball to Talon Jackson for the second out. Pop back behind play. 0-2 count, 2 down. Gonna be out of play to the right side. Crittenden on first base, maybe Van Ness batting. 0-2 count, 2 down. Off the end of the bat.
Little dribbler over to Lauren Hindley, who just grabs it, steps in the bag, gets us out of the top of the third inning.
Leading off for the Mounties, or the due up in the Mounties in the bottom of the 7th, Cadence Janney, Riley Johnson, and Ashlyn Hewlett.
Thank you.
Cadence Janney leads off the Mounties here in the third. Cadence is a senior. She's batting 385 coming into tonight, and she's tied for the team lead in doubles with five.
Low there. A little bit low.
That's a tough pitch.
Yeah.
Guessing from this view, I mean, looks a little bit low, but that's a tough one, again, for Cadence to lay off, but that's a good pitch by Van Ness.
Yeah.
So 2-0 count.
Oh.
Lined out right to the second baseman, Eva Reif.
Hit that right to her.
Next up for the Mounties.
That's tough.
16, Riley Johnson.
Now batting the third baseman tonight, Riley Johnson. Riley is a sophomore, batting 341 so far. First pitch inside. To an 0 count.
Gosh.
Line out right back to the pitchers so far. Van Ness has either caught or been assisted on four plays so far, four outs out of the eight. I'm batting the nine hole, number 15, Ashlyn Hewlett.
Left-handed slapper. Called strike. I don't know if he said she went. He must have said she came across.
Yes, yeah. She didn't pull it back. She was going.
Ball's outside. Makes it a 1-1 count.
Fouls it off. 1-2. Right, 1-2, got two down in the bottom of the third. Outside, 2-2 count. Count. Mounties looking for their first base runner still tonight.
Oh, dang. Gosh. It's like she almost, it's almost a defensive swing there.
Right.
Because
that
the
inside,
ball was inside.
Hit her.
And it was either going to hit her or she was going to make contact. She made pretty solid contact with it. Just went straight at the first baseman. Mm-hmm. We've hit more balls directly at defenders this inning than I've seen in a while.
So 33, score still 0-0. Leading off for the Lady Wolverines, the center fielder Olivia Thornton.
So we've got a couple. We've made contact with the ball. They've got two registered hits on the game, both infield singles. We've made contact, just driving the ball right at the pitcher, right at the second baseman, or right at the first base first baseman. But I feel like we're making good contact. We just got to find the gap. We got to find a hole in the defense.
Yeah, both pitchers so far are doing a great job of keeping the hitters off balance.
That they are. Seeing some pretty good pitching. I tell you what, a lot of people want to see high-scoring games. And I'm going to look into potentially – I'm going to try and find some way to get a camera out there in the outfield over kind of the shoulder, kind of where that center field dips down past the batter's eye. And I'll tell you what, it's a lot of fun watching games from that angle whenever pitchers are really doing a great job and just seeing their craft and where they place the ball.
Right, because you get that on-camera view of the catcher catching it.
Yeah.
And especially if, like Ava right now, she's placing the ball really well, if hitting her spots.
Yeah. So we're going to work on getting a camera out there. I was looking at – there's a hill back there. I got to find some way to get some sort of some mount out there so we can get that view. But yeah, this, I'll tell you what, great pitching night. Both pitchers have done a great job.
Line out.
We'll take it.
Right to Riley Johnson for the first out of the fourth. Now batting number 28, the second baseman, Eva Reif. In the second inning, she led off with a single, bounced over Riley's head, and Dahana couldn't catch her at first base.
Strike.
0-2 count. One down.
I think Eva was thinking that might have been a little high, but it's right down the middle.
Get off speed, just a little bit outside. Try to get her to chase. Got one ball, two strikes. Fouled off, out of play.
Ooh.
Good pitch, just a little bit outside. So two balls, two strikes.
Talent.
The second baseman, Eva Reif.
Yeah, 2-2. Talon tried to hold that there and say, hey, it caught the black there. The home plate ump is not having it.
So, Eva Reif's now 2-for-2. That one actually, that's their first hit to leave the infield. Third hit of the night there for the Lady Wolverines. Now batting the shortstop, Jaden Willard, struck out in the second inning.
Foul back. Foul back.
0-2 count, one down, runner on first base. Thank you.
one's fouled out of play, so we're going to hold here at the 1-2 count.
It was a good pitch to off speed, but she elevated enough that if Willer went after it, that she wasn't going to be able to do much with it. Well, high, 2-2.
Talon checking on Eva Rife first, making sure she didn't get too far off the bag.
Foul back. Still 2-2.
Willard is battling here. Sure where that missed, but we had one of those at the bottom of the last inning that we were kind of like, okay, but it's like he called it maybe up
high.
Or outside.
Yeah, had been high. That's a great location. So now we've got full count. Off speed, great pitch. Rife able to steal second on the strikeout. So got two down, runner on second. Now batting number 19, Katie Leonard.
Batting number 19, Katie Leonard.
Leonard struck out in the bottom of the second. Call strike, 0-1. Strike two. So no balls, two strikes. And two down, and Katie Leonard at bat. Ball got to the backstop. Rife able to get to third base. Throw it two down, runner in third base. And make sure we get Leonard here. It was a great pitch up and out of the zone for the third out.
Yeah, it's transfer runner. We'll take it.
Yeah, so the Lady Wolverines had a single in each of the last three innings, but Ava and the defense able to come back and get them to finish out the inning. No harm, no foul on it. Mounties will be back to the top of the order. Ava Johnson, Kylie Kelly, and Tahana Tumala here in the fourth inning.
Coach Harper just checking in up top here. Got a lot of I've seen several staff members here at the game tonight.
Yeah, one of our administrative assistants, Christy Bowman,
yeah.
who used to work at Bentonville West, whose son just graduated from Bentonville West. I saw her in the stands earlier.
Yeah, saw Miss Bowman. We've got several staff that used to be at West. Administrators.
So Ava leads off the bottom of the fourth for the Mounties. First inning, flew out to the warning track in right field. Just missed getting a home run to lead off the game. Our first two pitches outside, 2-0 count. Foul back. Just stayed in play. Great job by Laney Van Ness tracking that one down in foul territory right against the fence. And batting for the Mounties, right fielder Kylie Kelly. Kylie came in tonight leading the Mounties with a 536 batting average and also leads the team with two triples and six stolen bases.
First ball is outside.
Lined right to the third baseman, Laney Van Ness. Like Zach mentioned this last inning, we've gotten the bat on the ball a few times, but just right at either the pitcher, the second baseman, the third baseman lineouts. Hopefully the second time through we can start figuring maybe Van Ness out and getting some ladies on base.
The toughest part is they haven't had to move.
Yeah.
We've just hit it right directly to them, so they haven't had to move a whole lot.
Right after the leadoff fly out to right field by Evitz, we've had four ground outs to the pitcher, three line outs right at the fielders. Nice play by the second baseman, Eva Reif, able to get it to first base and to get DeHanna on the ground out. It's another three up, three down inning for the Mounties. They're still searching for their first base runner through four innings.
That one, the defense had to move just a little bit.
Yeah.
Pulled her over just a little bit. Made the play, it was bang, bang play at first, but managed to get DeHanna out there. So we're going to head to the top of the fifth inning. Like you said, still 0-0. No one's been able to get a run across the plate. Lady Mounties, we're still trying to get a base runner. I think it's just a matter of time. It's just you chop the wood, and you just keep hitting, keep hitting, keep hitting, and eventually it'll break. So I think we just keep chopping and we're gonna get see some base runners and get someone across the plate here soon.
Looking at some of the sponsors out on the big scoreboard, we got the Boar's Nest, the Gray Barn, Kite String Technical Services, all sponsored Lady Mounties Softball, Rogers K1 Speed, Sea Star Cleaning. All right, leading off the fifth inning, the first baseman, number 29, Maddie Axe. It's good placement. Axe showed bunt there. The ball's just a little bit outside. Off the end of the bat. Thought that was off the end of the bat.
They're going to say hit by pitch. Say went off her arm.
So he's going to confer with the first base umpire, the umpire down first baseline, but it looked like it hit off the end of the bat. Sounded like it hit off the end of the bat.
They're going to show her the bruise. The girl's got on first base. It's already there. Already there.
They're saying it hit her. She's on first. That's tough up here, but it just viewpoint and how it sounded like it hit the end of the bat. Well, so we'll say Maddie Axe hit by pitch, so she's on first base. Now batting Peyton Dilday, the right fielder. You know, where the umpire in the field's standing, that's a tough call for him too. So if it's not an immediate call by the home plate umpire, I don't think he's going to overrule it.
Right there with you on that.
Off speed, foul it back. So we got 0-2 count. In third inning, Dilday flew out to left field. Ashton Hewlett making the catch. That off speed pitch, it was a good pitch. I think it fooled Town a little bit. Ball got in the dirt and not able to make the play on Axe going to second base. The one ball, two strikes. Okay. Come back and get Dilley to strike out. I got one down. Now batting number three, Kaylee Parker. Parker struck out for the second out in the third inning, her first time up. All right, bunt to get the runner over to third base. Play you got to make there by Cadence, throwing it to throwing it to first base to get the out. So we got two down, runner on third for Stephanie Crittenden. Sorry, it's Heinle making the play, throwing it out to Cadence Janney on the bunt. Foul back out of play. One ball, one strike, at two down. Maddie Axe on third base for the Lady Wolverines. Lifted out of play down the right side.
Crittenden is making contact. Hasn't got one in play yet, but she's making contact with the ball. As soon as I say that, she
lifted to right field. Kylie Kelly able to make the catch for the third out. So strand a runner at third base, second inning in a row. Scores still 0-0 going into the bottom of the fifth.
There was no hit recorded that inning because she got hit by a pitch. So still looking at Rogers has zero hits. Bentonville West has three. No runs, no errors for either team. Just a solid pitching at him by both teams. It's actually fun to watch. If you like softball, you like baseball, it's fun to watch these pitchers. We've talked about it most of the game now about how well both sides are pitching. Placing their pitches, switching, changing speeds. Fastball followed by off-speed pitch.
Lady Wolverines getting a couple of pitchers up in the bullpen. Maybe trying to get Van Ness through this fifth and then get a reliever in. Leading off for the Lady Mounties here in the fifth inning is the catcher, Talon Jackson. Talon came into the game tonight batting .429. Tied for the lead with five doubles on the team. She's leading the team with three home runs and 24 runs batted in so far this season.
Okay.
ball's down. 1-0. Earlier in the game, Talon was the third of three batters to bounce straight back to the pitcher.
There we go.
Lifted one out to right field. That one's going to the wall.
Oh.
They did a good job getting the ball back in. Talon's held to a single. That's the first hit for the Lady Mounties. Hopefully that'll get the Mounties started here in the fifth inning. You know, the second time through the order, once they've seen her once, they're able to see her pitches a little bit better. So we got a courtesy runner for Talon, number 21, sophomore Izzy Anderson.
Coach Jeff Anderson's daughter, he's up here helping with the scoreboard as well. He coaches the freshman volleyball team. Izzy's going to get out there. It's a courtesy runner, get some speed on the bases here for Lauren. Lauren's up to bat with zero outs. Low.
Lauren flew out to left field in the second.
Looks like West is really guarding, really, really protecting second, waiting for a steal here, expecting a steal. Oh,
tough hop.
That was tough.
If that cleanly played, she might have been able to get Izzy at second base, but that was a tough hop. Came up and hit her in the chin. So runners safe. Got Izzy Anderson at second and Lauren down at first base for Mac Fithian, center fielder. On the base pass for Lauren Heinle is Tilly Garcia.
So, got runner in scoring position already. Zero out still for Mac.
Ball's up and away. 1-0.
And it's interesting to see how pitchers pitch differently with runners on the base. Notice that last night, the baseball game, changes the perspective a little bit. Had a little bit of some action in the field with runners on the base path. But they both went back to first and second.
Yeah, Max stabbed at the bunt attempt, and both runners were caught off the base, but able to get back. A 1-1 count. Off the end of the bat, foul back. 1-2. No outs for the Mounties in the bottom of the fifth. Just a little outside, 2-2.
There we go, updating the scoreboard. Sorry for the delay there. I was checking with the official score. Oh.
Gonna be a tough play.
Everybody safe.
Barely got off the end of the bat. Tough play for the third baseman. Base is loaded full of Lady Mounties.
Great base running there.
You know, she could have got Mac at first base. She turned to try to make the play at third. You know, fielder's choice gets her on base there. We'll take it.
Checking with the official. They're going to score that a hit. Single on that. Last one, at the first baseman whenever Eva Reif had that one kind of bobble a little bit. They went ahead and scored that in error. So I'm updating the scoreboard as we go. Okay, got you. Fielder's choice. Yeah, should fielder's be. Choice.
Yeah, because she should have been able to make the play to first. As she turns there looking for third, you know, it takes the hit out of the equation. It looks like the official scorer did score the hit. And now batting for Lady Mounties, number 23, Cadence Janney. Cadence got a good swing on the bat in the third, but lined out right to the second baseman.
Next, a 1-1 count. Outside.
Yeah, and she hit the glove right where the catcher was set up, but just a little bit outside. We talked about the beginning of the inning with Talon Jackson. The second time through, Lady Mounties has seen her pitches, seen her movement, so hopefully we get something going, and we've had three straight base runners. Outside, three balls, one strike. So Caden's going to get a pitch to hit here. See what she can do with it.
Trying to watch Coach Stafford on third base. She said, let's get a hit here. This is ultimate hitter's count. Base is loaded, 3-1. You know you're going to get something to hit here. Wow.
That was a great pitch. That right on the outside corner.
Caught the black.
You're looking. It's probably not where Cadence was looking.
I was
good pitch by Van Ness.
I was expecting something right down the middle, and she put that right on the black on the outside. There we go. Right back up the middle. Scores one.
Great job getting the ball back in. So just base to base playing by the Mounties. Kane's able to drive a run in. So still zero outs. Runners on bases loaded. Riley Johnson now batting. Off the end of bat, fouled down the first baseline.
Making some noise here in the bottom of the fifth inning.
Again, off the end of the bat, down the right field line, foul.
Just a little flare, just kept floating that direction. I'm looking at, I've not been to any of the away baseball or softball games this season, been to a lot of the home ones, but I'm interested, and we might talk about this at the break, interested in their shoe preference here, inside. Because I'm not sure how many infields are turf outside of here at RHS. Are you familiar with how many?
I think most of what we have in our conference we're playing with turf infield. And station batting by the Mounties. Riley's able to hit that into center field. Scores Tilly Garcia, who is courtesy runner for Lauren Hindley. Now batting left fielder, Ashlyn Hewlett.
Might be bringing a new pitcher in here. Yeah, I'm interested in that because they were might wear different cleats based on turf versus in the
right.
dirt. And so I've been looking at their. I like to look at shoes, look at what the kids are wearing, what the athletes are wearing, basketball out here on the diamond, and noticing the difference in the turf cleats versus the traditional baseball softball
right.
cleat. And oh no, I was down in Farmington. I know it's not our conference, but I was down in Farmington, and they were out there raking the dirt
mm-hmm.
and getting everything ready. So,
yeah, because even look at Gravett, who I think we play a home and home this year. They have a new field, new turf field.
Yeah,
their old field was dirt. There are a few around. I think Bentonville. I know at least on the baseball side, they're a turf infield and a dirt outfield, like a grass outfield.
Okay.
But I'm thinking everybody in our conference is similar to what we have, at least the turf infield.
Tell you what, Gravett's really, really call that outside. Gravett's really improved their facilities. We got mm-hmm. a new football stadium.
Yeah, new basketball arena.
Basketball arena, yeah.
Both baseball and softball, they redid their stadiums from right out there on campus now.
That makes a huge difference. And we used to play out at Veterans, and it's so much nicer to have it here on campus.
Right.
I've got a good friend of mine I used to work with who went to Gravett to coach soccer. They just got soccer out there. That's right. Maybe they just got girls soccer. I'm not sure. But anyways, he's a varsity soccer coach out there. Shout out Ryan Quintana. I'm not sure if he's watching or not. I doubt he is. But – yeah, Gravett's doing good things too, but you have to. Called strike.
Okay. Two balls, two strikes. Again, bases full of Lady Mounties, no outs here in the bottom of the fifth. And they've played it two so far on four hits. Fouled back, out of play. Ashton doing a good job just staying alive there, 2-2 count.
Let her cook chant coming from the dugout. Outside.
Outside, full count. Three balls, two strikes, no outs. And the bases are full of Lady Mounties. Job staying alive. She's fouled off two. Ashton's first at bat tonight in the third inning. She lined out to the first baseman.
That's trouble.
Tough play for Riley there. Yeah, lined out to the first baseman. She wasn't aware of where the ball was at and was able to and got doubled off. Heads up play by the first baseman.
She's looking over at third. She was looking to throw to third.
Mm-hmm.
Is that Mac on third? Was partially down the baseline towards home and scurrying back as quick as she could. And heads up play, who I got over there? Maddie Axe was looking at third to throw to get a triple play. But fortunately, able to get back. Still have runners in scoring position, second and third. That's a break Bentonville West was hoping for.
All right, base loaded, no outs. Able to get a double play there. Runners don't advance.
Didn't give up a run, yeah.
So now it's, you know, a little bit better position there for Mabry Vanessa on the mound. We got two down, runners at second and third.
Pitcher-pitcher matchup.
First pitch outside. Ava's 0 for 2 so far tonight. Flew out to right field to start the game. then popped out to the third baseman.
Gets ahead in the count. Avery gets ahead 3-0 in the count.
Fouled straight back. Three balls, one strike, with two down. Buddy Mounting's on second and third. That's a good off-speed pitch. Just a bit outside. Bases loaded, full of Mounties once again here in the fifth inning. Now batting the right fielder, Kylie Kelly.
Coach Stafford coming in to make an adjustment.
They're going to get a courtesy run at first base for the pitcher. Riley Fithian, your courtesy runner for Ava.
First pitch swinging. Flare down the left field lines. Gets foul.
Kylie's seeing if she can add to the two runs scored so far here in the bottom of the fifth.
Jams her.
So the Mounties have four hits, able to plate two runs. Through five, the score's now 2-0, Lady Mounties.
Big thank you tonight to our game time sponsor, the Yates family, and another thank you to Abuelos for sponsoring our pregame meal. Thank you for supporting our Rogers Lady Mounties.
Leading off the Lady Wolverines, top of the sixth, number 27, Mabry Van Ness. Mabry's 0-2 so far tonight. Pop foul to the catcher, and then grounded out to the first baseman to end the third inning. Nahata making the play and got her. Now batting the center fielder, number 6, Olivia Thornton. Olivia's 0-2 so far tonight. Ball's outside in the dirt, 1-0. change here by Tori Stafford. It's like Rayleigh Wagner. Come in and play second. Cadence is going to go to the bullpen and warm up. Rayleigh was a flex player tonight, not batting, but she was ready for flex just in case there's a change made. Straight back.
Right back at us.
A one ball, one strike. One down here in the sixth. Over the right fielder's head, all the way to the wall. And Olivia Thornton in the second with a double. That was over Kylie Kelly's head, bounced and hit the wall. Great job getting the ball back in. A Rogers Mounties baseball team is also playing Bentonville West today. They are over in Centerton and leading 7-0 in the fourth inning. Ty Anderson's doing a great job. Three innings pitched so far, two strikeouts, only one hit.
Popped up to Lauren Heinle, who makes that play in foul territory.
Up to bat for the Wolverines, number four, Jaden Willard.
So we got two down, runner on second base, and the shortstop, Jaden Willard, batting for the Lady Wolverines. Willard's 0-2 so far with two strikeouts.
Good pitch, just misses.
Mounties baseball, like I said, 7-0 so far. They scored three in the first, two in the fourth inning. Only have three hits. Seven walks by the Wolverine pitchers so far. So Mounties doing a good job of going base to base. They've stolen, looks like, six bases so far. So, you know, only three hits, but seven runs. And with Ty Anderson on the mound, that's a pretty solid lead for him.
Yeah.
Fouled straight back. One ball, two strikes. Got two down. Runner on second. Looks like we got Daylin Osborne and Cadence Janney both warming up in the bullpen. Another pitch fouled back. That's a good pitch. Change her vision there. 1-2 count. Give her a rise ball. See if she'll swing at it. So 2-2 now.
Off speed.
Popped up to Riley Johnson down the third baseline. Lady Wolverines got a runner to second and stranded. So one hit, still no runs. To the bottom of the sixth, the score remains 2-0, Lady Mounties.
Thank you for supporting your Lady Mounties.
Lady Mounties softball is co-hosting a tournament this weekend with Heritage, as our Lady Mounties will play Prairie Grove on Thursday, Harrison and Pea Ridge on Friday, and then Houston Christian out of Houston, Texas on Saturday. And then we're back here Tuesday, back in conference play with Fayetteville Lady Bulldogs, 5 o'clock on Tuesday. Now batting for the Lady Mounties, number 27, Dahana Tumala. Dahana's 0 for 2 on the night. Ground out to the pitcher in the first and grounded out to the shortstop to end the fourth inning. Off-speed pitch down the dirt, 1-0.
Right back up the middle. Get down for a single there.
Yeah, second baseman able to get over to it, but in the outfield grass, or outfield turf, if you will. And Dahana's able to get to first base. Now batting Talon Jackson, who led off the fifth inning and got the Mounties started with a single. First hit of the game. First pitch outside, 1-0. Dahana's on first base. No outs in the bottom of the sixth. Down to third baseline, just foul. Coach Stafford reliving her playing days, trying to make a stab at that. Balls up, 2-1 count. Foul back out of play, 2-2. Ball's inside at full count. Dahana Tumala on first base.
Hammers
rifle down the third baseline all the way to the wall. Dahana's going to round third, score easily. Talon Jackson into second with a stand-up double. Hard hit ball through the infield, and the left fielder was not able to get over and cut it off and made it all the way to the wall.
That's a scorcher just right down that left field foul line, third base foul line.
That was Talon's team leading 25th RBI on the season. Courtesy runner Izzy Anderson out at second for the catcher Talon Jackson. Ball's in the dirt. Is he able to get to third easily? That 1-0 count to the first baseman, number two, Lauren Heinley. So we had no down, no batters out, runner on third base. Good off-speed pitch. Just caught the outside corner. Outside, two balls, one strike. Outside in the dirt, 3-1. Got Izzy Anderson on third base. No outs here in the bottom of the sixth. Ball four got past the catcher. Izzy Anderson able to score on the pass ball.
Up for the mound, he's number six, Matt Fidio.
Smart base running right there.
Yeah, so Talon had a double. Izzy able to steal third, ball in the dirt, and then able to score on the ball that got past the catcher to the backstop. Matt Fidio batting. We got Heinley on first. We still got zero outs. Mac 1-for-2 on the night, singled in the fifth.
Sees a second ball outside.
Side 3-0. Ball's lifted. Left fielder coming in, able to make the catch. So we got one down, Cadence Janney. 1-for-2 tonight. RBI single in the fifth.
Tell you what, Coach Stafford is definitely very aggressive. The second hitter tonight I've seen swing on a 3-0 count. You think they're going to take, but she's aggressive. Says if you see a pitch you like, swing at it.
Now pitching for the Lady Wolverines, number 19, Katie Leonard. Back in play here in just a minute. Rayleigh Johnson, third baseman, will be batting. I'm sorry, Cadence Janney's batting for the Lady Mounties. Yeah, Lauren Heinley on first base after the walk. One down. here in the sixth inning. And Cadence Janney is your batter.
First pitch. Call it in the dirt. It's a fastball up and in. So, stark difference between her first pitch and her second pitch.
Sure, bounce that one in the dirt, 2-1.
Not sure what that is. If that's a pitch she has that is just coming off her hand, a little bit different tonight. Because it was slower. I feel like the first pitch and the third pitch were a little bit slower off speed.
Inside, 3-1.
That one was a little faster, just like the second. If that off speed pitch is coming off her hand a little bit different, we'll see if she settles in here. I got 3-1. I accidentally gave her a strike. Right up the
ball. Was afraid of able to track it down. Thought that was going to get over her head.
Me too.
Just stayed up in the air just a little bit too long for Riley. That's going to be for Cadence Janney. Lauren Heinle still on first base. We got two down. And batting is Riley Johnson. Yeah, that off-speed pitch is just a little bit down. She's not getting it quite to the plate.
I think it's a pitch she's comfortable with, mm-hmm. but for some reason something is it's coming off of her hand different tonight than what she's used to. She hasn't made a whole lot of adjustments on that pitch yet.
Line down the left field. Heinle advances to second on the single by Riley Johnson. The runners on first and second, two down, Ashlyn Hewlett. Batting for Lady Mounties. Ashton's 0 for 2 tonight. Both at bats, line right to the first baseman. The fifth inning, was able to get a double play after Riley was off the first base bag on the line out.
Just enough of the black on the outside.
And we saw that with the very first pitch of the game, Ava Johnson threw a pitch on the outside corner and he called it. And you could tell he's going to have a liberal strike zone on the outside. That's good, though. Make him swing the bat, put the ball in play. All right, a strikeout. Ashlyn Hewlett, the third out. Lady Mounties able to play two. The score's now 4-0 going into the top of the seventh.
David Johnson's sticking in to complete this game here.
Leading off for the Lady Wolverines, and here in the top of the seventh, Katie Leonard. Leonard went into pitch there in the bottom of the sixth. She's 0 for 2 so far tonight with two strikeouts. And I say that, now we have a pinch hitter, number 5. Whitney Sherry is going to lead off here for the Lady Wolverines.
The West coach is just watching the stream thinking, man, I'm going to mess these guys up here. I'm just kidding. Yeah, right on cue.
Lefty-lefty matchup here to start the seventh.
Check swing.
Great play. Riley Johnson able to come in and get that. Throw to first base, and Heinley's able to dig it up out of the dirt for the first out.
Actually tried to pull the bat back and then ended up catching the ball, and it went right to Riley Johnson, who made a great play on it.
Got a one down. Now batting the first baseman, number 29, Maddie Axe.
Maddie made it all the way to third base. Hit by pitch and then managed to move to second and then to third. Mm-hmm. They couldn't get her home, but she's been probably the furthest, the most advanced base runner they've had tonight.
Fouled straight back out of play. 0-2 count. One out here in the seventh.
Potentially four strikes away from a Mountie victory.
Fouled out of play on the right side. Still 0-2. Ball's up, 1-2. Lady Mountie's hosting a tournament this weekend, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. We'll play four games.
Got a doubleheader on Friday, don't they?
Yeah, they play 6 and 8 on Friday, 5 o'clock on Thursday, and then noon on Saturday. So come out and support your Lady Mountie softball this weekend. Ball's outside, 2-2. Fly right to Ashlyn Hewlett there at left field for the second out.
Lady Wolverines down to their final out.
Peyton Dilday batting. She's 0 for 2. Flied out in the third and struck out in the fifth. Ball one outside.
And a baseball just landed in left field.
Our C team playing Bentonville West over at home.
It's a pretty good foul ball.
Yeah.
I was like, wait a second, that ball's white. It's not supposed to be out here. Got neon yellow.
Swinging strike, 1-1 count, got two down. Top of the seventh, Davis trying to finish out the game.
Be nice to have a shutout here at home before the tournament.
Strike two.
another high fastball. Put it right past her. I'm going to predict another high fastball.
That 1-2 count, yeah, just get it up out of the zone.
I would be wrong. Someone bounced in the dirt just short of the plate. Yeah. She's keeping us guessing.
But you're changing her level there, so now you got an off-speed down the dirt. Like you said, go back to the high fastball.
There it is.
Strikeout Ava Johnson, 3-3 down inning to end the game. Lady Mountie victory 4-0.
Fantastic. Great game. Love to see a good game with some good competition here. Yeah, so we are going to be back here for Lady Mountie softball on Tuesday. We've got Fayetteville at home. And before we get – yeah, we should be here Tuesday for Lady Mountie softball. If you want to watch the baseball team, we should have them Monday for Springdale here at home. So we will be streaming both of those games. So come back next week, catch the baseball team, catch the softball team. My name is Zach Land, and I'm joined with Mike Leafgreen, doing all the heavy lifting tonight. I greatly appreciate it. Thank you so much.
It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's great. It's awesome whenever we get to call a game and the players are playing well. It's awesome to have a victory, but the players playing well and have a victory, it's a lot of fun to watch. So yeah. Thank you for tuning in. We're going to wrap it up here, and then they'll start the JV game here shortly, I believe. So thank you. Thanks, Coach. I appreciate it.